Well, hello, everybody. Welcome to Table Talk. We are glad you're here. I am glad that I'm here with Pastor Zach. Zach, it's your turn to say hello.
Hello, friends. So glad that you're joining us at home, in the comfort of your house, hopefully around the screen. We just had a great time around God's Word yesterday, hearing from Pastor Billy about God's call. And speaking to the friends at home, why don't you tell them how to get the resources?
Absolutely. If you go to our website, it's simple. It's FBCFO.org. And if you go to the very top right, you'll see some drop downs. Click on the one that says watch. And what you'll find is chronologically listed the most recent sermons in sermon series, special ones like we had yesterday. You'll also find tied to those table talks like we're doing now. And then you'll find a going deeper guide for each one, which we love to put in your hands that you can use as a resource, whether you're spending time personally in God's Word, maybe you're mentoring somebody, or perhaps you're part of a group. We encourage you to use these resources. You said something that I want to ask you to clarify on. You said we had a great word from Billy. Yes, tell us what happened here yesterday. Yeah,
yesterday was a special day in the life of First Baptist Church Fort Oglethorpe. We had a pastoral candidate. His name's Billy Crystal. And the church confirmed him as the next senior pastor here at First Baptist Church Fort Oglethorpe in both of our services. And this was an exciting day to confirm him. Him and his family were here. And so just to see what's next that God has for both him and this church and the community.
Sure, that's great. Yes, we absolutely did. And Zach, I just want you to know that that means that you're on your way out, because our relationship was as an interim pastor, and you had a unique role to fill. It was, in a sense, open-ended, but it gave us spiritual leadership. It gave us community leadership. It gave us leadership in the teaching of God's Word, and you led our staff, and we appreciate that. And now we're in that transition time. So we're not getting rid of you yet. In fact, we have several weeks ahead where you'll be with us and we'll be doing this together. You'll be preaching in our services, and then we'll have some transition time. So, Zach, let's talk about that word that Billy brought to us, Pastor Billy did. It was great. It was powerful. It was about listening to and responding to God's call. And I know, as you and I were talking earlier, how he wove in about how God calls sometimes with a immediate one-word call. Sometimes it's over time, and sometimes it's just by selection where you get picked and you go, oh, but God uses that. Tell us about something in your life, how God called you.
Yeah, I really appreciated the way Billy just kind of unpacked that and walked through those bold calls and those being called over time. And I resonated that in my own life. And I remember being between my senior year of high school and being a freshman year in college, I remember being in the Word, and I remember listening to preachers and listening to missionaries. And I remember that bold call that, as he talked about, here I am, send me, Lord, hearing that. I remember God speaking to me so clearly, a call to vocational ministry. As he said, we're all called to ministry. We're all called to do the work. But I remember a specific call to ministry. But even resonating with Billy's story of, didn't really do anything with it at the time. But over time, God started to, through the encouragement of other people, saying, hey, I think you should do youth ministry. Hey, I think you should teach Sunday school. Hey, I think you should volunteer here. Over time, I started to just serve in youth ministry, started to serve in the church. And here I am, 25 plus years later, still serving in ministry, but realizing this was God's call on my life. And so sometimes God calls us that big, bold, and we need to step out in faith. And sometimes it's over time that God does that.
Wow. And thank you for sharing that, because I think all of us, even when we're not in professional ministry, all of us, as you said, we're all called by God, and he uses those ways. That's great. One thing else that Billy shared was about being a servant, being a slave. And he made a statement that we in the Western culture, United States, Europe, whatever, we truly don't understand what a servant or a slave really means. Spend a little time on that for us.
I love how Billy unpacked that. And he talked about, Paul said he's a bond servant. He's a slave, some of our versions will say. Or even when he gets to Ephesians, he talks about being a prisoner of the Lord. Wow. That we are a slave to God. And it is. We have this idea of what it means to be a servant or a slave to God, but we don't see that every day. Paul saw that every day, what it meant to be a servant or a slave. And when we talk about understanding God's call, that becomes our life. That becomes, so when we listen to God's call, And it doesn't, and we don't have to be someone that's a pastor, someone that is a music minister or a children's director. It doesn't have to be that. We are all called to the ministry. We're all called to serve our neighbors. We're all called to witness. We're all called to love our neighbors. And but also understanding that as Paul laid out, as a prisoner, as a slave, that I'm first tied to Christ. More than anything.
Wow. And boy, that's great. Thanks for helping with that, because yes, we don't live in a culture of servant and slavery, but if we understand what Paul lived in, he lived in that. And so he put himself in that position as an example for all of us to follow, to be that servant, to be that slave to Christ. And he even says that. He identifies himself that way in multiple places. He starts by saying, Paul, comma, a bondservant or a slave of Jesus Christ. You can see that in God's word. That's a great thing that you brought back for us. Thank you for that. Listen, we are so glad that you chose to be a part of this time with us. And we want to pray for you going out. But know this, we are doing this because we want all of us to experience life change. Transformation. That's why we spend time in God's Word. That's why we spend time with other believers in mentoring relationships, in small group, in discipleship relationships, because we are seeking to become more committed to Christ, following after Him in everything we do, so that we can become disciples who make disciples, who make disciples, who make disciples. And it goes on and on. Zach, I'm going to ask you to pray us out. Can I do that?
I'd be honored. Thank you so much, Pastor Brad. God, we love you. We thank you so much for just your goodness to us, your goodness towards us. And as Pastor Billy even closed out his last few points of application, you're desperate to reveal yourself to us, God. We thank you so much for that. We thank you for what you're doing in leading Pastor Billy to us. We just pray for these coming weeks and months. Pray that you give him favor and the church favor as you are building unity and building wisdom and direction and vision in this church. We pray for just that your heartbeat for the community, your heartbeat for the lost, your heartbeat for mission would just be center, God. That it would not be about our agenda or building our name or making our name great or making even First Baptist name great, but about making your name great, Lord. And I pray that you would bless there. I pray that you bless our folks at home, Lord, who are seeking your face, God. I pray that you would just give them encouragement. Thank you for your love for us. And we pray all these things in your Son, Jesus' name.
Amen. Well, we're going to say goodbye till next week. God bless you as you chase after God.